Hello, Nigeria. My name is Dari Anigiero. I'm here live in New York City to spread the gospel of Take It Back. And before then, I want to introduce Dr. Njakir Damages.
Welcome to the show. My name is Dr. Damages. So coming to you from the greatest city in the world,
New York City.
Yeah. New York City is so great.
It's great
that we had 0 degrees temperature.
Zero.
This weekend.
You lied.
Were you not freezing like this?
I was like this.
So it was horrible. 0 degrees in New York City. Can they survive in Africa with zero? you know Africa is very easy to deal with ladies.
I look.
Yeah. And also in Washington DC, it is hot, getting hotter. In Washington DC, 230 miles from here,
yes,
getting hotter there.
Yes, exactly.
For President Trump, do you know why? For the first time in the history of the United States of America,
for the first time,
the President of the United States,
Donald J.,
had to come out and deny that he was a secret agent of a foreign country.
Wow!
Take a look.
I never worked for Russia, and you know that answer better than anybody. I never worked for Russia. Not only did I never work for Russia, I think it's a disgrace that you even asked that question, because it's a whole big fat hoax.
I know.
Donald J. Trump.
I know. Isn't that wonderful? Poor Trump. The FBI, his own FBI, opened an investigation to see if the president was a spy, an agent of Russia.
Open book
for him. I said, I know. Now, you worry that your president is a clone or a body double. imagine this one. This kind of nightmare.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Trump is being accused of working for America's number one enemy, Russia. You know,
Russia!
This is happening when most of America's government, federal government, is in partial shutdown.
Is it why it's a puppet?
Partial shutdown. The government. Most of you don't know.
Yes.
Even the cooks, who cook for the president at the White House, they are not going to work there. Leaving the president to eat only fast food.
Jump.
Look at him now. Look at.
Now, what's your favorite thing here, Mr. President?
I like it all. It's all good stuff. Great American food.
If you visit President Trump now, he will order pizza for you. No, the wife doesn't cook now. Can't you see that? She doesn't know how to cook.
She cooks Russian food.
She doesn't cook. Now, for those of you who do not know, the cost of the government shutdown was because President Trump wanted to build a wall.
The wall, yeah.
Demanding for $5.7 billion.
What?
To build a wall at the U.S. border with Mexico.
Mm, south border.
You know? Now, until last week, I did not know that President Trump was God sent.
God sent.
The war that he was talking about was written in the good book.
Of what?
Sorry. I don't mean good book. The good script.
Yes.
You can't make this up. On May 9th, 1958, an American TV show called Take Down. I had an episode that featured a con man named Trump who wanted to build a wall to protect Americans. It's unbelievable. You know what? If I tell you, you won't believe it. Watch.
I know. It's a Western TV show from the 1950s. It was called Trackdown.
Right.
And it aired on CBS.
I know.
Right? And it features, this is true, it features a con man. And the con man's name is Trump. And that con man tries to justify building a wall.
Don't roll the clip yet. The only way I would believe this is if this con man said that he was the only man that could make it happen. You know what? Roll the clip.
Only one. Trust me. I can build a wall around your homes that nothing will penetrate.
What do we do? How do we save ourselves?
You ask, how do you build that wall? You ask, and I'm here to tell you.
You're a liar, Trump.
What did that man say? Did you hear what he said?
He said,
you are a liar, Trump. No, I'm not. It's not all.
Yeah.
Guess how the episode ended.
Yeah.
Okay, tell them.
The sheriff of this town, who's the hero of the episode, the last line of the episode is, you're under arrest, Trump.
The sheriff of the town said, you are under arrest. That's how they ended the episode. You see, I'm done.
Right.
I'm done. I don't know what to do. You know, I'm moving to where? London.
The eyes to the right, 202. The nose to the left, 432.
The eyes to the right, 202. The nose to the
London. I'm moving to UK.
Wow. Because
the near has it.
Yes.
Do you see what happened there? Even you, London. You know, even you. Now, that was the sound of mayhem in Britain.
What?
With that vote, Britain's dream of planned exit from European Union, called Brexit, was voted down in the House of Commons.
Wow.
Nobody knows. Well, why the people in the West are resolving their issues by investigating a sitting president and jailing a standing prime minister. In Nairobi, Kenya,
yes,
it was with bombs and AK-47 that Africans are resolving their issues.
Wow.
Yeah, on Tuesday, an Islamic terrorist group called Al-Shabab,
they
attacked a five-star hotel in Nairobi, Kenya.
Hey!
I was in that hotel a few
years ago.
I was in that hotel. It's in an affluent Westlands neighborhood in Kenya.
What?
At least 15 people were killed.
Wow. Oh my God.
And scores of people injured.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Oh God. Oh God.
Africans, who did this to us?
Who did this to us?
Until you start providing me answers, I will keep asking that question. Who did this to us?
Who did this?
Why are you behaving like this? You see, the New York Times newspaper, you know them.
Yes.
They ran into trouble when they published pictures of victims of that attack. Pictures.
Yes.
Kenyans were furious.
Wow.
And they let the New York Times know that they were furious. They showed it to them. Look at the tweets.
Wow.
The paper doesn't publish pictures of dead Americans when America is attacked or dead Europeans. But when it's Africans, they display it for the world to see.
Shit,
objects of this. Yeah, to them we are shithole.
Hey!
You need Kenyan newspaper. You see, the Kenyans force them to apologize.
Yeah, of course.
Now, this is just a reminder. Pastor Owusu, Ghana, and Apostle Suleiman of Nigeria, they both released together 100 prophecies in 2019.
Yes, yes.
None of them saw this attack on Nairobi. None of them saw it. Don't forget that.
What?
I'm just telling you.
Now,
talking about things that you should not forget.
Mm-hmm.
The 2019 presidential debate in Nigeria is taking place. By the time you watch this, it must have happened.
Yes.
As expected, President Muhammadu Buhari was a no-show.
No-show.
Yeah,
go for medical.
Not because he almost collapsed at a campaign event.
Thank you very much for staying with the station. As
no, that wasn't why he didn't show. He just didn't feel like showing up. You know what I mean? He felt those people were beneath him. You know what I mean? No, he didn't. You know?
Just vote.
But Buhari showed up at a town hall meeting. You know, town hall meeting that took place on Wednesday.
Yes.
He was there with his vice president, debating the vice president. We don't know who won.
Oh,
no, we are just debating. But we got this clip of Buhari talking about the governor of Kano State.
Gandola.
Watch Buhari.
That clip, somebody brought it me. How the governor of Kano State was receiving dollars and smiling and putting it in his pocket. I don't know the extent of technology used, and I can't understand it.
Wow!
I know, that was Buhari trying to tell us that he doesn't understand the technology.
Protecting the
he saw the man collect dollars. He said he does not understand the technology used in making that video.
Protecting Ghana.
Do you know the technology used in making this video you're watching?
I don't know.
I told you that the man has no plan of debating anybody. Mm-hmm. After that Arise TV interview. Did you see that interview?
Yes.
After that, he was done, you know?
Nothing to offer.
He was done with talking to people, all these people, Shore and all these, they have been eating. You know?
What?
He was done with debating. Now, in fact, he was done talking with the media.
Yes. What?
The next time Buhari will talk to Nigerian media is September 2019. When he comes to the UN in general.
Oh, exactly.
That's the next time he will talk to the media.
What?
Did you say to Fiapa?
Oh, no,
I know. In that Arise TV interview,
NTA.
Yeah. Where was asked why he was retaining the IG of police? After his retirement age.
I know.
Transmission.
Yeah, transmission man. Here is Buhari's answer. Watch.
Yes, I saw it on the television. Somebody has given me last warning that I must. Well, I have seen it. Is one of you?
Why didn't you tell this man?
Yeah, Amachi. Why didn't you tell us that the man watches TV? Amachi didn't tell us. He told us that the man doesn't read the papers. If we knew he watches TV, we'd be going on TV to warn him.
Yes.
Give him an ultimatum. Warn him.
Yes.
Give him quick notice. Mm-hmm. Because he watches TV now.
Yes, exactly.
And
read newspapers.
Newspapers. Anyway, after much pressure on Buhari, he said this.
I will take action.
He said he will take action. And this week he took action. He removed the IG of police. And he replaced him with an assistant inspector general of police.
Yes, yes.
Muhammad Abubakar Atiku. You know the guy?
Yeah.
Most Nigerians were interested in knowing where is he from.
Yeah,
that's the first thing. Once
the
mention embedding
first
them, where is he from? Where is he from? Well, the man is from Lafia in Nasarawa State.
Nasarawa!
What does that tell you?
I hope he brings Allah.
What does that tell
you? I hope he brings Allah.
Now, the other question people were asking is, how many people will be retired to make him the substantive IG? You know, all the people on top of him.
DIGs.
Deputies, Special General Police.
All the
them.
Seniors.
How many? All the seniors, they have to be retired. Yeah, yes, so that the man will get to the...
They got to go.
Yeah. Is that not a waste of resources?
Yeah, I know. Waste of manpower.
Waste of manpower. But that's how they do things over there. You know, now, in the same interview,
yes,
Buhari said something that should worry Nigerians more than where IG of police is from.
Yeah, the ethnicity.
Yeah. Oh, you should.
Ah!
When he was asked, why was he saying, claiming that there was food security in Nigeria?
Yes.
When Nigeria is now the number one country with the highest number of poor people in the world.
Yes,
after
exactly.
India.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the point. He was, so how could you say we have food security? When 87 million Nigerians live in abject poverty.
Yes.
That's when you don't wear slippers or shoes to go to church.
What about the man with no shoes?
Yeah.
There will be a conflict because you work with figures. I work with facts.
What?
I know.
What?
Ladies and gentlemen, that brings me to the end of the show.
I'm done.
You know what he said? You deal with figures. I deal with facts.
Ridiculous.
I need a drink. Somebody give me something to drink.
Let's go on this one.
When Arise TV people went on break. My crack reporters, you know my crack reporters?
Yes.
They were able to sneak in few questions to Buhari. The first question they asked Buhari, you know, he was relaxed, he was laughing. Mr. President, your Minister for Transportation has been going around saying bad things about you. The only thing you said was that, you know, you don't respond to people talking in Biapalo. That you don't respond to Biapalo conversation.
Yes.
But some people think that you were afraid of Amaechi. That's why you are, because he knows where they bury the bodies. That was what my crack reporter asked him. Look at his answer.
I don't think I'm afraid of him.
I know. Now, the second question my crack reporter were able to ask Buhari was, your wife said that he was begging Nigerians to save you from the cabal that are in control of your government, hijacked your government.
Yes.
They said to Buhari, why should we be talking to you when you are not the one running the government? Wonderful question. I know I trained them very well.
Hey.
Look at Buhari's answer.
What? Thank you very much for alerting me. You even know more than I do.
Hey!
Wow,
he's
serious. Now, that answer baffled my crack reporters.
Yes?
It baffled me too. Baffled me. No, they say to the president, is it that you don't know what to do? Is that all you can do?
What?
Listen to his sense.
What else can I do?
at that point, my crack reporters, you know, basically, they just said to themselves, you know, in this case, we definitely need to pray for Nigeria. Because if this is how the president is, we have to pray for Nigeria. This is what Buhari said.
I think the administration was lucky. We prayed very hard to God. Sometimes people who are incompetent, they pray too much.
Oh my God.
Where is Amechi?
Amechi?
Even this is not a good example of a Dr. Tep.
Yes.
I'm telling you, this is not a good, don't think this is what we just did is a good example of a Dr. Tep. Mm-hmm. It's not. I recommend that all of you should watch the whole interview.
Yes.
In its original form.
Mm-hmm.
You will walk away 100% sure.
Yes.
That Buhari is not a Nigerian elite.
Mm-hmm.
Or a clone.
Yes.
Or a body double from Sudan.
Yes.
But a simple man.
Yes.
From Daura.
Huh?
Who is too self-righteous.
Yes.
And full of righteous indignation.
Hey! Too much.
To condescend to the level.
Yes.
Where he will understand. And or play with the complexities
of
modern politics in a multicultural society that is under intense stress from multiple angles. Sasha! In other words, this is the translation of what I just said.
Okay.
In a 19th century world,
yes,
Buhari is good enough to be a commissioner of agriculture in Katsina State. That's all.
Mm.
Nothing more.
It is 150 cows.
Commissioner of agriculture.
Not in transmission era.
Nothing else. Not in this 21st century. Meanwhile, at the other debate of candidates,
yes,
who were excluded from the main debate.
Yes.
From the main
debate.
The candidate for the African Action Congress. Clash with the moderator. When the moderator tried to stop him from calling the names of people who destroyed Nigeria.
Why not?
They said it's part of the rule of the engagement. Watch the encounter.
The same way we can talk about Saraki and the rest of them who are the major operators of the PDP. We have to mention names. There's something we can do about it. Because people destroy this country. They have names. They're driving cars. They register the cars. They're living in mansions on our back. And we are here saying, don't talk about them. I'm sorry.
It's a rule of the debate, sir.
We have to talk about
them. If you are part of this debate, you have to keep the rule of the debate. I'm afraid. You have to keep the rule of the debate.
Brilliant guy! Brilliant guy!
You have to throw one of them red meat. This is red meat. Red meat.
Exactly.
No, at the point, they had to mute Shore. He was just talking, but nobody was saying anything. I'm like, these channel people, damn, not playing. You know, how I wish Shore had his own TV channel, you know, where he could debate, you know, when I guess I will never be invited to any debate. You know what I mean?
I know.
If you cannot call evil by its own name,
yes.
How will you be able to shame it? How?
I don't know.
I don't think they will invite me. By the way, by the time you watch this show, maybe the Chief Justice of Nigeria, Justice Walter Onnoghen, must have been docked at the Code of Conduct Tribunal.
Yes.
For what did he do again? For non-declaration of assets.
Assets.
You know what I mean? The Chief Justice
of Nigeria.
Of Nigeria.
Hey!
Will join illustrious sons of Nigeria.
Yes.
Like Bola Tinubu.
Yes.
And Bukola Saraki.
Inside the dock. Oh my God.
These are great Nigerians.
Oh my God.
Docked for lying about their assets.
Big man's dock.
Now, some people think that the Chief Justice case was politically motivated.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Because 3 days after they got the petition, they gave him a court date.
Yes.
3 days.
After that.
Meanwhile, petitions against Abba Kaira, the Buhari chief of staff,
and the
against Rotimi Amaechi,
yes,
the transportation minister, against against Ababi, who is now the best friend of Buhari.
Yes, yes.
They've been collecting dust.
Yes.
For years, under the table of EFCC, ICP, CCP, PPD, all nonsense. They have not given the court dates. Nothing. I'm for holding public office holders accountable.
Mm-hmm.
But it has to be done across the board.
Yes.
Or the government will lose credibility.
Yes.
And credibility is the most important thing the government needs to get things, other things done.
If there is any at all.
Secure credibility.
Hey.
True fairness, equity, and justice, and other things shall be given unto
you.
I'm talking to you, Buhari. I'm just telling you. I'm giving you advice. Tweet that out. If Buhari had publicly declared his own assets,
exactly,
like President Yar'Adua did,
yes,
and made everyone in his government to declare your assets publicly,
yes,
we won't be facing this embarrassment. We won't be facing this embarrassment.
Double standard. Yes.
So it's terrible.
Double standard.
But now, we're at a point where the Chief Justice, just imagine this, Chief Justice of America,
the number five citizen,
being docked.
Going
to jail. He might go to jail.
What?
Now, I'm sure some cabal somewhere, who wanted his Chief Justice to get away? Maybe laughing. They are laughing. They have something on everyone.
Yes.
They always use it to get rid of people when they don't want you anymore.
Exactly.
Like this one.
The
only way that NGO that filed that petition will be able to get this information is if somebody in the security agency or even in the CCB leaked the information to them.
Exactly.
That's the only way.
You know, the cabinet.
That's what I'm saying.
Doctor, why didn't they catch it before now?
I'm giving you that. Why it is
now?
Politically motivated.
Yes.
Having said that, that is the fact that he's politically motivated doesn't mean that he shouldn't face the music.
Exactly, you're right.
He has to. I don't care. Yes. He has to. Let him answer questions. You know, because if you look at it, all those judges, if you look at them, their kids are abroad here, going to expensive schools.
Mm-hmm.
How did they? All wrote. They all wrote anyway.
Yeah.
So I'm not. I don't have sympathy for him. I don't have sympathy for all of them. I'm not. No sympathy for them. Nonsense.
Nonsense.
If it took 3 months,
yes,
to vet the man.
Mm-hmm.
Why is it that nobody saw the red flags?
Yes.
You know, Mr. VP, I'm talking to you. 3 months. Why? Buhari signed the Freedom of Information Act.
Yes.
Remember?
Yes.
But he will not release his assets.
Yeah, exactly.
And he will not tell the CBB, the CCB, to release it.
Yes.
After several requests from several organizations,
yes,
including the Sahara people.
Imagine that. You request that for it.
I said they're all jokes.
Imagine. Jokers.
Jokers. Nonsense.
Justice.
Anyway, how is our president in waiting? How is he doing? I will
ask you. President,
what did he do last week? Other than waiting for the FBI, what did he do this last
week? He was campaigning.
He's still waiting for the FBI to
campaign. He was ready to campaign.
He was campaigning. Oh, yeah. He promised that he would keep his promises.
Yes.
Did you hear that?
Yes.
No, he promised that he would.
Yes.
Watch him.
I am committed to privatizing NNPC. I said it. I swear, even if they are going to kill me, I will do it.
He said he is going to privatize NNPC. Even if they will kill him. Good man. I'm sure nobody asked him the follow-up question, which was, those government agencies, companies he privatized when he was VP.
Yes.
Where are they now? Right. How are they helping
us?
How are they helping us?
Yes.
Nobody asked him that question. Did he sold?
Nonsense.
Those government companies that he dashed to his friends and proxies, and you know, how are they helping our nation? These are the questions reporters will ask. Well, at a Channel CV interview, Atiku explained how it will all work out.
And I'm also not going to enrich members of my family, but my friends. Are my friends not entitled to be enriched?
Never again.
He said, I won't enrich my family,
but
I will enrich my friends.
Oh.
From the man, from his mouth. You know,
provided they are not corrupt.
He will enrich his friends.
Joker.
He won't enrich his family, but his friends, they will be all happy.
Enriched.
Nonsense.
Never again.
Are you his friend?
Never again.
If you are his friend, you should be happy.
I have.
He's planning to enrich you. You know what
never
I mean?
Never again.
Anyway, now in the last few days, there have been so many political violence everywhere. Did you follow this story across Nigeria? Yeah, look at. No, let me talk to young people. Let me talk to you. In the upcoming election, you know, my people, listen to me. Do not die for the politicians. Their children are already abroad to watch the election from London and the US.
Yes.
No. If they are in Nigeria, they are all on YouTube. If they are in Nigeria, they are in the affluent areas of Nigeria. Where the crisis will not reach. If you die, you die for nothing. Here is Bola Tinubu talking about political violence. Watch.
With our children, our junior brothers, and many of our followers, we want our followers to become sacrificial lambs.
He said it. They will sacrifice you. You.
Exactly.
Not their children.
Yes.
Did I say it? Play that in again for them because they missed it.
Wow.
Anyway, this is an update on our man Dino Melaye. Dino has been acting
Dino
this month.
Melodrama.
It's been going on for a long time. And there are some kids now who are basically making a career out of playing Dino. You know what I mean? Look at
your beauty is fine. You say that his BP is high, it can't be treatment and can't be treatment. So how long do you think this thing can take? I don't know.
You see, our elders, they said that when a snake loses the thing that makes it a snake, they can use it to tie firewood.
Yeah,
children.
Exactly.
That's what it's happening. This is a senator of the Federal Republic.
Exactly.
They're using him to tie wood.
Yeah, yes,
firewood. That's it.
Wow.
Nonsense.
Here are some stories making headline news across Nigerian newspapers this week. Rihanna sues her own father, for exploiting her name.
Fenty.
Without permission. You know,
Fenty.
I like it. You know,
that's
in a counter suit, Rihanna's father sued Rihanna to stop her from using the name he gave her.
That's bizarre.
She's claiming that the father's name is now her property.
Yes.
Wow. You know what I mean?
I like the counter motion.
No, exactly. Nonsense.
Counter.
Oh, this is wonderful. I have been fair to Igbo people despite the low votes, says Buhari.
Hey!
You know Igbo people gave him the low votes.
Of course.
He's still penning him.
No, he's penning him.
He said he's been fair to them. He gave them 5 ministers.
You'll never.
5 ministers?
Yeah. According to the 1856 Buhari constitution, you know that?
Yes.
The number of votes you gave a president is directly proportional to the number of ministers you get.
Why
did you do the constitution?
It's very clear, it's equal to constant.
No, yes. You are smart. Thank you, Baba. Thank you very much. This is the beginning of a new thing happening. EFCC naps bishop for defrauding people in God's name.
What?
I think the EFCC, they've crossed the line. They crossed a very, very bad line. You know, because when you start arresting bishops for defrauding people in God's name, where would they stop? And what space would they? Where would they keep all the bishops and pastors that we arrest? I mean, can you imagine that?
I mean,
it just
come on.
They need a train to be picking them up from every
space.
Because is that not what all of them are doing?
Yes.
Why are they picking on that guy?
Put them on mass.
The whole bishop.
They've lost it.
On sales name.
They've lost it.
Nonsense.
Oh, this is about the Chief Justice of Federation.
Onnoghen.
We will shut down Nigeria if the federal government fails to withdraw charges against the Chief Justice of Nigeria.
Is that a threat?
Niger Delta militants. You see, this is what I'm talking about. for you to be somebody in Nigeria, you have to have people who are ready to shut down the country.
Yes.
If anything happens to you.
Yeah, bold enough.
Do you have people that will shut down the country if anything happens to
OPC.
You? OPC. OPC. Yes, that's true. You know, if they pick me up, you know what I will do?
Yes.
I'll call my friends.
Which
your
friends?
I'll call my friends. Say, Nico, your brother at the Epidium.
We are so blessed.
Now, this one, you will never believe this happened in Nigeria.
Mm.
A brain surgery has been successfully carried out.
Yes.
At the Muhammadu Buhari Specialist Hospital.
Mm. Where's that?
Kano.
Kano.
I'm a doctor. This is a difficult surgery to do.
Commendable.
Now you can write your own joke. You know, think about brain surgery. Murtala Muhammadu Buhari Specialist Hospital.
What?
Brain surgery. Buhari. Brain surgery.
Correlation.
See what I mean?
Correlation.
In Kano. You see what I mean?
Correlation.
Write your own joke.
Right.
I can write everything for you.
No more London.
It's time. Yeah.
No,
you see what I'm saying?
No
this
more
guy
London.
Is thinking. Write your own.
No more Asura Clinic.
Think, write your own. And the dollar is already there in Kano. You know what I mean? You see? Yes. This is how they do it. This is how they do it.
Welcome back.
Happy New Year.
Yeah,
thank
happy
you.
New Year. I understand that you went to Nigeria.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
He came back to.
She was hanging out with big names.
Big
names. Okay, yeah. I mean, we saw the pictures with bishops. That level. Is this a human
being?
So, how was Nigeria? Did you bring anything for us?
It was fun. Yes, Nabichi Ukwa straight from.
Hey! You know what that means?
Your
teeth, I think your teeth
is
no, you don't have that kind
of it.
It's not strong enough.
Americanized teeth, they can't get over. You know, anyway, so
Ashley State is in, you know,
big people, you know, big people. No, my crack reporters, they follow you once you once you come into Nigeria, they follow you. I'm more money.
I have a question for Adoji. Did you see Dino
Malai?
I saw it. In action.
All right. So, do we have emails today?
Every day, doctor.
Okay, let's hear them, please.
Okay, so our first email is from Ismail.
Ismail. Oh, Ismail. That's my friend. Yeah, yeah. From
Zamfara.
Zamfara. You know, the situation there. You know. Mm. Yeah, what does
so
it mean?
So sad.
Mm.
He said, hi, doctor.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm a big audience of your show.
Good.
And I'm addicted to your program.
Thank you,
ma'am.
I want to lodge a complaint regarding the killings and kidnappings from my state, Zamfara. I never heard you reporting the bloodshed happening on a daily basis.
Yeah.
I need you and your team to make an episode regarding the killings and kidnappings terrorizing good people in Zamfara, Sokoto, and some parts of Katsina.
Oh my God.
Regards to Sasha, Agege Bread, the noisemaker, and the entire crew that makes this broadcast happen. Thank you. I'm looking forward to hearing from you.
Thank you, my friend. Thank you so much for writing and bringing this issue up. We try sometimes, but you know, this is a depressing issue, is it not?
Yes, it's so depressing.
You know, we don't want to want people we want people to get home, and when they watch this, at least they will be kind of inspired, and maybe they will smile a little bit while getting these stories. But thank you for bringing it up, and we keep hoping that the minister for defense, you know,
yes,
the guy,
he's
from Zamfara. If he cannot defend his state, you know, the military and the police, what hope do we have?
The president from Katsina,
what hope do we have? You know what I mean? There's no reason why this should be happening.
Yeah, exactly.
This, you know, and they want another 4 years. What do you think?
Never again.
All right, next.
Our second email is from Chudi in London.
Chudi.
Yeah,
so many. I know two of them. Okay, go. Let me. Depending on the question, I will know which one.
And he writes,
yeah.
Dear Dr. Damages,
yes.
I can see how the political forces are aligning in Nigeria.
Uh-huh.
When do you think an Igbo man will be president if Buhari wins?
If Buhari wins?
Yeah.
Ah, my friend. Ah, this guy is thinking too much. It's actually good that he said this, because I have been doing the calculation.
You've done the math already.
I've done the calculation.
Mm.
You see, look at it this way. If Buhari wins,
mm.
In 2023, the VP will take over. and the VP will be there for 8 years.
Yes.
Okay. That will be 2031.
Yes.
And then it will be the turn of the North.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And the North will rule for another 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
That will be 2039.
Mm-hmm.
Then we will come back and see whether developments have better chances than
Liberation,
you know what
two.
I mean. But the good thing is that before then, the Savior will come back.
Yeah, exactly.
From
Thank
Israel.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy,
holy, holy, holy.
Namdi Kanu is another Savior.
Holy,
I mean, they can do what they like with the presidency. We are waiting for the Savior to come back.
Yes, you know what I mean? Exactly.
Yes,
Israel. Our final email is from Akorede Akonji from Canada.
Canada, up there. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And he writes, Dear Dr. Damages.
Yes.
Are you a normal person?
Wait. It's been long that people attack me. Go ahead.
He said, are you a normal person?
Okay.
I have written several emails to you, but you haven't read them.
Hmm.
I can tell Shoyo to terminate your employment with Sahara Reporters.
Sorry.
And you will be jobless.
Uh-huh.
I think the noise maker smokes cigbo.
Oh yeah. Oh no, you're right. You're right about that.
Because it makes a lot of unnecessary noise.
You're right about that. But
there's a truth to every joke.
I don't see how. This is who me. Does this guy know who I am? Does he know?
He said, "Are you a normal person?"
Jackery, damages. What is that my title? What is that my title from my village? You do know.
Okay.
This title they gave me now. Fire all these people first. Before fire them. I'm not going to watch something like that. They always give me a big title. You don't respect me here. That's why these people write letters and talk about firing. I beg, can you bring the guy? Make it not right. I beg, my man. Call me. Make me talk. I don't take the Fugari from my table.
Our guy is busy.
The man is busy on the campaign. He doesn't even know what's going on.
He doesn't have time.
You know? Yes!
That's what we have for
that's
today.
I'm just wearing two emails. Anyway, that's all the time we have for emails. Please keep sending your emails to drdamages@gmail.com. Follow us on Twitter at
drdamages.
And on Instagram at
drdamages.
Now, here's my concern for today.
Uh-huh.
It's taken from page 419
uh-huh.
of the book, The uh-huh. Secret Letters of President Donald Trump,
uh-huh.
by Jack Hales.
Uh-huh.
And it says, success is on the same road as failure.
Mm.
Success is just a little further down.
That's deep.
It's on the
that
same road,
deep.
But it's
same
just
road.
A little same further path. Down.
That's
so
deep.
Keep pushing.
Have to continue.
I go deep to bring
yes,
this up.
Mm.
Until
deep.
Next week, I'm Dr. Damages. I diagnose
you yourself.
Are you afraid?
Hey, I don't
so, know. So you went to Nigeria eh? Mm-hmm. and just enjoyed for how many weeks?
Was it
and,
for 2 weeks?
And we were so? Here paying you.
This
kind of thing I do. Nobody gives me credit.
Yes.
Nobody. She was relaxing at home.
Drinking wine.
What did you bring again? Opa. The hard thing.
Do you have Opa in America?
Why not Suya? Didn't you see Suya?
Don't worry, next time.
Nkobi.
His eye is busy.
This is not things like that. But anyway, welcome. It was good.
Yeah,
good. Mama Udoka was looking at her. She was looking at me.
What's Udoka?
Udoka was sitting down there.
Looking at her.
Udoka was looking at you.